One, two, three. We love it. We love Jaisalmer. We love Jaisalmer.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome back to our channel. I'm Ed.
And I'm Sally. We make travel series here on YouTube every single week, so make sure you subscribe to become a part of the travel tribe.
Today, we are in India, and we are exploring the incredible golden city of Jaisalmer.
Sunrise over the Gadisar Lake, which is the lake right here behind me. And now this lake is a pretty popular spot, not only with tourists, but also with local people. As you can see, it's got the ghats right here. They're the stairs that lead down to the water. And like the other ghats that we saw in Varanasi and also in Pushkar, people do use the lake to wash clothes, hang out with friends. It's kind of like a bit of a social space. And we have seen that there are some boats. Hopefully we're gonna be able to hire a boat and actually get out on this amazing lake this morning.
Unfortunately, we've just discovered that the boats are closed today. Must be due to the end of season, or maybe the boat guy's sick. In which case, we hope he's better, because coming boating down here on the lake during sunrise would be absolutely incredible. Because as you can see, the lake is just surrounded by these beautiful temples, shrines and ghats, and I think being out there on the lake just to be able to enjoy it and see it as the sun hits the golden sandstone, I think would be truly, truly awesome.
Next up, we're going to be heading into the Jaisalmer Fort, which is one of the, I would say, like the main attractions aside from the desert here in Jaisalmer. And what's really interesting about this particular fort here is it's actually a living fort, which means that people still live inside. There are restaurants, cafes, hotels. It is completely bustling, which is totally unique to all the other forts that we have been in here in India. And I have actually heard that it is one of the only living forts in the entire world. So this is not only unique here to Jaisalmer, but it's also unique in the world. Let's go.
So the Jaisalmer Fort is the second oldest fort here in Rajasthan. It was built in 1156 AD. In my opinion, this is one of the most impressive forts, and it is because of just this gold sandstone color and architecture within the fort. It's just truly incredible. I could literally spend all day just walking around looking at the different buildings here. So a bit of a game you can play as you're walking around the town is like try and pick the old buildings from the new buildings. So this one here, you can tell from its facade and it's got the hand railings, that this is actually a new build within the old fort. So a lot of the buildings have tried to mimic the oldest style. So if you have a look at, say, this building through here, that's a much older building compared to this one. It's just interesting to walk around and sort of have a bit of a look and see if you can spot the differences between the two different styles. The fort is actually really, really cool. So because so many people live here, you get these like beautiful shops and hotels and restaurants right next to ruins almost. And so when you're walking around, you don't really know like what's going to be around the next corner. It's all these like mazes and alleyways and temples and stuff. It's just fun to go and explore.
As you're walking around the fort, you'll notice that a lot of these buildings have these paintings here all over the walls. Like you'll see them pretty much everywhere you're walking in the fort and also outside of the fort as well. And interesting, we just found out that these are actually wedding invitations. So what families will do is they'll paint on their walls the wedding invitation, basically inviting everyone in the fort to the family's wedding. But really cool, really fascinating. So we've seen, like, this one here is from 2019, but we have seen a few from like 2017, 2001. I think we saw one yesterday from 1999. So it's kind of cool. It's like a little bit of history painted on to all of the walls here. This one's from 1999. That's cool.
So there's also a whole bunch of Jain temples here in the fort, which is awesome. I think there's seven that you can go around and try and have a look at. Ah, I rode a bike! So there are seven Jain temples here inside the fort. All of them are beautiful. All of them are really old. But it's kind of like, you gotta try and find them, you know? There's no map. That's the best part. You have to kind of like wander around and just try and find these temples as best you can.
It is important to note though that if you are going inside, entry will cost you 200 rupees and you will need to take off not only your shoes but also any leather products that you have on as well. They are not allowed inside the temple. And the temples are only open from sunrise until noon, so this is a morning activity.
So one of the really cool things about just exploring the fort is seeing how all the different people live. And the people that live in the fort, they're actually descendants from the original workers, the Brahmins and the Jaiphurs, who used to live and work here in the fort. So it's crazy to think what it would be like, you know, growing up here. You know, if you were a kid, it's like something out of Aladdin. You'd be like, feel like you'd be jumping across rooftops and having such a fun time, you know, just playing inside the fort is literally every kid's dream. But if you're thinking maybe you want to buy a house here, I've got some bad news for you, because you can't actually buy them. They're actually passed from family to family.
I know, such a shame. How fun would it be living in a fort? Like buying a place inside of a fort. You're probably going to want to come and explore the fort really early in the morning. We're here at the end of March, start of April, which is getting into the real hot season, where temperatures do average 38 degrees in the middle of the day. So you're probably going to want to just like have a wander around in the morning while it's still cool enough to do so. Because trust us, once it gets to around 11 a.m., it is way too hot to be wandering around. It just no longer becomes enjoyable.
This is ridiculous. Like, check it out. It goes all the way over there. All the way. Look at it. What a huge wall. Huge wall. It goes all the way around. Absolutely incredible.
Dish that is called pan puri, and what it is like these little, I guess the only way I can think of it to describe it is like tortilla crisps, and in the middle they stuff it with all different kinds of stuff and then they put sauce on top. Great description, Sally. But that's what it looks like. Let's see if it's like spicy enough. Thank you. So many flavors on this, I don't even know like where to begin. The guy who was making it sprinkled like so many different types of seasonings, and then there's like this white cream sauce. Also, it's topped with onion, coriander. There's also like what looks like dry noodles. I'm sure it's not dry noodles, but that's what it looks like. He also did ask if we wanted it spicy, and I said yes, spicy. So hopefully it's like Rajasthani spicy and not white people spicy, because I'm on a mission to find food that is spicy enough for me. Do you reckon you put the whole thing in your mouth at once? That is like a little flavor explosion in your mouth. Wow. It's almost like Indian nachos. As weird as that sounds, this is like Indian nachos.
Cheers.
Indian nachos, right? Like,
so nice. I mean, it's not spicy at all. Not even for me. I love how they've picked this as their spot to lie down. Not over there. Literally in the middle of the road. It's madness. Look. Look. This is where the cows are. How about that view, hey?
So there are obviously like tons of rooftops inside the fort that you can sit on and have dinner, but the reason we've decided to come here is because of this amazing view over the whole fort. Like you can literally see the whole one side of the fort. And it's golden and beautiful and the sun is setting and there are birds flying everywhere. And we're up a level, so we're not on street level, so it's a little bit quieter up here. And it's just a good spot, really.